Hey, good morning, everyone. And here we are back with Russian Fishing 4. And the game does not want to load this morning. Let me have another crack at it. Bear with me. Yeah, we'll just give another go here. On our way back, that won't be long. Hopefully, third time lucky. And there we go. We're on our way. Okay, so first day here on this map. I did do about a sneaky half an hour here last night. Just one spot. And I caught a few little fish. So that's probably where we'll start the day. Looks like we're coming in at night time, so I don't know really what our night fishing options are here, but anyway, we'll find something to do. Okay. Now I just have to remember how they got there. Yeah, so we're not going after anything specific or special today. Just trying to have a little bit of fun. I must admit, this is graphically a pretty little map. So, another quick check. Yeah, we're on the right track here. Yeah, this is where we were. So look what we've got happening here. What are we going to put on? Let's stick a red worm on it. And okay, we did have a clip on that one. Hoping that's the right clip. We'll leave that one on. As I said, I've absolutely no expectations here whatsoever. Yeah. Where's this one? heard plenty of bell action, but I don't know which one it was. Yeah. It's had to be a meter, I remember that. The mayfly on there. Yeah, I probably should have cast that up the river. Pretty fast moving here, isn't it? Once the sun gets up, I think I'll go back to spinning. I was spinning here yesterday. Yeah, I'll give that up for a minute. Yeah, I'll stick with that one. Where are we? Yeah, okay, we'll stick with this one. Little fish on. Little's the operative word here. Pontic shad. 64 grams, no tag on him, so we'll put him back. Another little one. A This one's a little bigger than whatever that one was, but a little perch. Another little perch. Turn that off and just get out a little bit further off there. Size of these guys. Another little tiddler. Another little perch. Oh, you've got another tiny fish here already. Crazy. Oh, it's a keeper. It's got a tag on it. Was a little better. Asp. What's happening on those bottom rods? But this thing's firing all four cylinders. Another asp. Not bad XP for little fish. I don't know what a trophy size would be for an ass. Probably a lot bigger than what we got here at the moment. What do we got on this one? Half kilo perch. So it's interesting to fish somewhere new just to find out what fish are there, because I've got no idea. The only two times I haven't got a fish on this is when I've had to put it down to get a fish off the other one. Oh, another small fish. There is a downside here so far, is the small fish. They're just crazy small. There we go on that one again. So I've got red worms on our ID. I think I've got caddisfly on the other one, I think. Not doing so good. This is no monster though, is it? Tiny little bream. Can't even turn him into bait. Too small. Yep, this is tiny as well. What have we got this time? It's a tiny little pontic shad. It must be close to a tag, because what was the 114 was tagged and he was 101. Anyway, let's play on a little bit. I've got a few other spots we're going to try. This is very peaceful here. No fish. First time, I think, that I've wheeled it all the way in. Wee. What have we got happening here? A greedy little fellow, this guy. What's the run of it? Oh no, 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 you bastard got off. God damn it. Oh. Oh well. Go back and try again. Looks like there might be a fish on there as well, is it? Not very big though. But then again, we're not catching any big fish. We're not doing big fish day. Really casted that far out. This is a lot of reeling for a tiny fish. Another little bream. Just get to the edge here this time. Lot to know what that other bugger was that got off. Oh, there's another one jumped off. First chub of the day. There's certainly plenty of variety here, even though not a lot of size about them. I think the bigger ones have to be somewhere. Yep. Anyway, as soon as we get near the green patch there, we pick up a fish. It's a baby perch, I think. Oh, got the tag. He's keeping. We're keeping him. tiny fish. A rudd keeper as well. Oh, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 keepers. It's not bad. Let me just have a quick look at the map here. Where do we want to go next? Okay, maybe back up here. And what do we got here? Well, that's a keeper bream, that one. That was just on the edge there. Not leaving that far, to be honest. Let's give them a look at a different lure, see if that makes a difference. No, not that one, he says. We a little bugger. Another smallish bream. So far, our more exotic bait has not caught anything. Well, it's an interrupted cast, so we'll give it another go. tiny fish. I think the lure's nearly bigger than the fish. Little shad. We can go back. I think after we recover this one, we'll go do some more exploring. See what else we can catch. I didn't even look in the cafe to see what the cafe orders were. We never got a bite on this one. And we've got a feel on the old red worm, so I don't think it's too far of a hike back this way. Right, lad, walk around the boat. Okay. Quick check my notes here, what we want to do. Do we want to go a bit further up, I think? Let me quickly check the map. That's problematic. I think that one's on the other side. Okay, we'll give this one a go. What have we got here? Small 16, I think. Mayfly. Could probably do without that. No, just chuck it out there, eh? See what happens. What would we end up with here? I might take that one off as well. Small hook on. Let's try a blood worm, why not? And I guess we can flick a lure here, I don't know. See what happens. we don't do any good with this, we'll pull the float rod out and have a little play with it. No, doesn't want to hook up, or does? Well, tiny fish, but anyway, it's a fish. Let's see what we get. Nice. Keep up. We'll have one more go with this. If we don't get one, we'll pull the float out and have a crack with the float. Yeah. We'll try this one. Close enough to a meter. We'll wait for a hook. We'll stick a mayfly on here as well. Yeah. As soon as you get this in there, it's always going to go, wasn't it? White-eyed bream. We'll keep that one as well. Yeah, I'm not. These floats are moving way too fast for me, and I like it. And what have we got here? Oh, a sickle. So that's obviously my first ever sickle. Not worth too many XP points, but it's a tick in the box in my bag for sure. See what we got here. Another wide-eyed bream. We'll keep plugging away for them because it's getting tapped again already. Maybe not. Let's go back to the red one. I think the that's a decent fish. Perch, maybe. One kilo, nice. What have we got now? Another nice, a bit small this one. He can be keeper for bait. Let's check the quiver tip. Oh, it's on the bottom. Pull it up one. Let's say they had to cast this one as well as the other one. Anyway. I wasn't planning on getting the chop up bait here, but I guess sometimes you never know, do you? Okay. I'm certainly having some fun on this rod. Another undersized wide-eyed bream. Well, nearly time to give up the spinning with the let's put another bottom rod out there. We haven't set this one up from last fish. Turn that off. Now medium 8's fine, and we will go with. Let's try a maggot. Make sure there's no clip. There was a clip. Okay, in the next daylight session, I think we're going to go in here somewhere. And this time we've caught a what? A little roughy. Okay, we'll take that. I got a fish on it. No. I might have to put a sinker on this one. The cage is a bit light. Yeah, only 30 gram. Put that on. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. 10 species of fish out of 14. he must have got off, did he? Or he was never on there. A little bit of weight on the maggot here. Oh, nearly 3 kilo bream. We'll keep them all day. No problem at all. Keep on coming. I wasn't planning on doing bream fishing, but I'll be taking them at that weight. Oh, I think this middle one's going to have a sinker on it as well. Yep. Cages just aren't holding them on the bottom. Okay, well, I'm not disappointed, even though I've only got 15 in the bag, throwing a whole heap back, 10 different species. What I haven't checked is, oh, that's a big ass. I was catching 2 kilo one before, and well, not quite two. So what do we think we're going to catch here? Well, whatever that is, what's that bait? Well, the actual mayfly, we haven't got any of them. Bleak we could get, bream, obviously, burbot we can get, hopefully we don't get catfish. Chub, clupinella, we could get them, 29 grand, that's tiny. We have some casters. Well, I mean, we could chase common if we wanted to. They're a pretty common race. We could get crucians. Crucians on algae, interesting. Onion garlic, though. Dace we can certainly chase up. Mayfly we don't have. These one we may have a go at later. We've got plenty of red worm. Frogs give us grasses as well. Okay. Milk peach. Obviously, good old potato. Honey that. Yeah, so we got, we caught one of these. I caught one of these yesterday, first one. Tiny little one. We've caught them now. We've caught these. We haven't caught this one. What's that like, an eel? Wonder where you get them. Not wildcat, we haven't got any of them. We'll have to find that spot. I haven't got any of these baits either, but we can get them. So yeah, there's plenty here that hello, we've got two on here. There's plenty here that we haven't caught yet. And to be honest, I don't even have spots for them. Well, it looks like a river mussel. There you go. And another river mussel. Yeah, Farrow is from the cafe. Oh, it's up there. Some, it's up here, I think, isn't it? Wait till the sun comes up and we'll go and have a look, see what's up there. Do some investigating in the daytime. So 1 hour down, 17 in the bag, which is not a lot, but it's the variety I'm impressed with. 11. And this was a new one, the sickle was a new one. I actually caught a rudd yesterday, so it wasn't new today. I caught a shad yesterday, but these three have new in this river. So yeah, it's been pretty decent, I think. Sometimes it's a bit better doing this than sitting there looking at three big carp rods waiting for something to happen. Another little love tap. Just too small to be cut up for bait. I think that one should have a. So the key to this spot that I got here was someone that was here catching dace using a bolo rig, but I think they just float way too fast. I don't think it'll be, gotta put some lead on this one, I think. Only got another couple of hours here before the sun comes up, and then we'll go do some investigating. $70,000 couldn't hold it. Obviously it's empty, but all right, what's this line going here? This is more than likely, and well, I don't know, it's a guess. Another river mussel? Yep. Not even a keeper, really, is it? Yeah, when you don't hear the old bell ringing. I reckon we've let at least 10 go, maybe more. But we're probably up sort of like around the 30 fish in an hour, which isn't too bad. Well, I think this is the quietest it's been since I dropped the first line in this morning. An hour ago. Finally, so it's gone a little bit quiet. Well, it's crazy quiet now. That's all right. Sun will be up shortly and we're going to bugger off. I wanted to the fish go off the bite because I put those sinkers on. Haven't really done so well since I put the sinkers on. Bait size. Let's get rid of this and go to we'll go this one and we'll put a brain mix in there. See what happens with that one now. See if that entices any more bites or not. I mean, for bream fishing, we've actually got the wrong size hook on and the wrong bait, but yeah, bream will take anything. Four o'clock in the morning and the sun's coming up. Someone could write a song about that. Well, hang on a minute, I think somebody already did. I just can't remember who it was. We'll give it a little bit of daylight time to see if any comes on the bite in the morning. I'm getting a little bite in the middle there. Well, whatever it is, it's not very big. Tiny white-eyed bream. Tell you what, put him away. Right, let's fire up into the buildings up here. I've got no idea which is which at the moment. These houses are nothing by the look of it. What's this one say? That one's got to be something, surely, with a sign on it. Nope. Okay, grocery store. It's got to be the admin. I did see the cafe yesterday, but I can't remember where. Well, that's the boat down there. And a tackle store, we want to go in there in a minute. It's not the cafe up there, is it? It's more like at the hardware or something, is it? Bakery. Okay, we can buy moonshine here. Well, the only place used to be able to get it, used to be able to, was it Volkoff? You had to make it yourself. Homemade bacon. Bread, okay. Well, I didn't know that was there. Anyway, there you go. This was a tackle shop, yeah? Yeah. Well, this one, was it? No. No, it's nothing. Fish market. No, oh, just there it is there. And a nice looking cafe it is as well. Right. 2 pieces from 180. Well, we've got none that big. Didn't catch any of them. Didn't catch a zebra. Didn't catch any of them. Okay. We did catch some of those, but none that big. Okay. So we probably haven't made much money then. But we're not here for the money. Yeah, white-eyed bream's tasty. Yeah, I mean, it's not disaster. $60. Ah, I'm happy with that. Well, now, where do I want to go? I want to go to A3. A3, up there. I just got to follow it up. I don't know how long it takes to get there, but I'm guessing this building something here, is it? Let's have a quick look. Shop Vacula. I was going to go on that. Oh, okay. specialist hooks, floats. Certainly can't afford them at the moment. I want to go back to the tackle shop. Sorry. Check out the bait. If you can actually buy the mayfly, I'm not sure if you can buy mayfly or not. This was it here, I think. Yeah. Baits. Insects. 522. I don't think I'll be buying those. All this stuff's pretty dear here. Flies are cheap enough. Yeah, I don't think there's a fish here that's worth paying that. I just wonder how much these are worth at Volkoff if they're the same. Anyway, I won't be buying them. So we'll go up this way. I don't know if this building does anything here or not. Can't see a door. Oh, the workshop. Okay. The old church. There's nothing. Nothing you can do with that. They could have got a bit more imaginative the scenery here. Yeah, I think that's just a bit lazy of them. Okay, well, this must be the spot here. Look at the map, or 7.3 spot there. Car southeast, which kind of makes sense. I'm aiming at that. Well, I'm aiming at it now. Yeah. What have we got on here? We go a bit more than that. Yeah, we can. I did have some medium eights, so we'll try a medium eight. I want to use Nightcrawler, so we'll do a Nightcrawler first. Just make sure it's no clip. God, he knows if you catch anything here in the daytime, I've no idea. Have a look what we got on this one. 14. Another 9.7. We'll stick with the medium 8. Might even try a red worm on this one. I'd actually like to try one of them, but I don't know which one to try. So this might be a nighttime spot, I'm not sure. We'll have a little flick around. What else can I put on here? Well, I couldn't put that one on. I can't put those on. This one's fine. Oh, something out there. Nice little chub. Find his mother out there somewhere. Did we just get lucky with that one? Okay, go again. Slow it down, I think. Thank you. Okay. So, it's a bit light, that one. Try one of these ones down. What's going on there, bro? What they have on there? A red worm, I think. No? Still thinking about it. Okay, well. He must have been the one and only chub in the whole top end of this river. There we go. Something decent here, I don't know what it is though. They can run me out. They can run me out either. Well, just have to wait for him to tire himself out, I think. Chasing back up again. Think about it, I've got no idea what leader I've got on this. I think we're kind of winning here. Certainly recovered a lot of line off him. Little ripple on the water there, he hadn't break the sail. Oh, there he is. Oh, I'm still none the wiser. Oh, what's a bloody pike, you bastard. Okay. Oh, and I only got a fluorocarbon. Might cost me fish by putting the steel on there, but yeah. I don't want to be losing the lure either. Not nothing on me. About that one. Yeah, just... Might be a little fishy on this one. A little being the operative word. Like a baby bream to me. Not worth the effort. Well, hopefully we don't get too many more pike. Of course, the other option is to change rods over and target the pike. I don't know how many of them are here. Tiny little thing hooked up here. Look nice in a fish tank, that, wouldn't it? 58 grams, 12 centimetres long, probably be a good size for a 4 foot tank. But no tag on it. That's another tiny fish, this one. Well, there's even on there. Well, it's still there. Oh, buddy, how the heck do you get that mouth? A happy fish. Little smile on his face there. Happy fish. Now let's suck that hook down. Well, what we do here is we take the medium 8 off and we put a large 1 on there. And we might just change the bait. I don't want to put potato on there. Put a normal worm on there for a minute, see what happens. I've got a funny feeling this is because you're aiming for that big hole, it's a nighttime spot. It's not that far away from nighttime, so we'll ride it out. Guess we can put these on. Let's see if they make any difference. Whatever it is tiny. Well, at least you got a tag on him, that one. It's a long way to cast to catch a fish that size, but on and off, little bugger. Wasn't very big though. Try this one. Okay, we'll go back to these little guys and try them again. Can't cast half as far with it, but let's make a slight adjustment here. straight down the throat. And the way this one's taken off, you'd have to suggest this is another pollock. Maybe not quite as big as the last one. Certainly gave up a lot of these in the last one. Whatever it turns out to be. slightly smaller, 1.8. Okay, one more cast, and we'll if it's a 10 kilo one out there somewhere and he comes along, he's going to break us off. Park this one up. Let's get rid of all these bloody snags. Let us quickly go to the records. Some of the carp. Let's have a look at this guy. Sunflower, I don't have. Peach and herbs. I've probably got some peach and herbs, something, I think. And peach fluoro. Could put potato on. I don't really want to be catching these things. It's all right, I won't catch them, but what I got? Cheese, I don't know where they are, though. Same as these things, I'd fish for these, but I don't know where they are. I mean, you're not fishing very much, 85 gram fish. Wilds, night crawls, well, we've got a night crawler on out there, halibut, pellets. Okay. Let's do this. Where are you? The model one in it. Same in here, I think. Now, what did I have? Only pepper and mussels. I'll cancel that and we'll go back to you. So we got two pop ups. That honey cream, not that other one. Oh, that's right. Peach and herbs was one. Okay. We'll just go and pop up all the artificial corn. Peach and herbs. Peach fluoro. And spicy peach. There we go. We've got a decent thing there. Turn the clip off. And see if we catch anything on this. This thing sounds like it's running. Jesus, man, is it going or what? Woo, 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 woo. I can see an exit coming up here. Be back in a minute. Okay, we're on our way. Wow, okay, well, that's a definite change of setup up there. I want to get back up there, though. I'm keen to find out what that was. So, that was big. Get them carp rods out and get up there. This will be a run, forest run, and get up there and get up there and get amongst them. That was just on night crawl, that one. So we'll do a night crawler in line rig. We'll just leave that one we just set up with a boilie. And I might go potato on the other one, I think. Make sure I'm heading in the right direction. Which we are, and away we go. Let's get back up there. This could be some fun to be had there. Let's go. That helps. Put the headlight on. Right, so we'll do a quick setup change here. Right, we can get this one in. Okay, and we're just going to change this to a loop rig. I'm going to paint that off. And we're going to put a cage on there. I'm going to put some of this one in there. We'll leave that. And this one, we'll put a night crawler on. Why not, he says. Make sure the clip's off. Class retrieve, set this on about 28. Get this one out there. Longest cast, very nice. Let's just hope that's not too far. And this one will go to a loop rig. I got you, bro. We'll just go for that one, leave that on there, and we'll put potato on this one. Make sure the clip's off. Well, that 35 is probably far enough here. I 220, I'm just going to throw 100. What's our Nightcrawler getting tapped on there? I do have somewhere. This one. Seversky Donets. Okay, that's not the one I'm looking for. Oh, yeah. No. I've got a map somewhere of so it can tell me how far I should be casting there. Okay, so that long distance cast was probably decent, and the others are probably short. Anyway, I want that other fish to come back, the one that whacked us before. He doesn't stand a chance now. Now we've got the power rods out there, they're not biting. Anyway. All the learning curve for this map, first day here. I do find it very relaxing though, the scenery and everything in this map is amazing. We've been going for 2 hours. What did we cash in the first one? About 17 fish. We've got 4 now, 21. The people throwing a lot back. About 12 different species now. I think we count the pike. We already had a chum of the nights earlier. Yeah. So it's been a productive day as far as sea species go. I don't think this one's out far enough. Go on, take it. You won't peel this one off like you did the other one. Probably barely far enough there, 61. It's all bugger eyes around that middle one. Stop now. I don't know if he's on there or not. There he is. Well, this isn't the one we're after, though. Get off my line. I don't know why people would come to here and cast 70 meters, because that's what they tell me. Aim back at the 7.3 hole. With a full cast. I mean, you could probably come here somewhere. I guess you can go here and go that way. I don't know. Let's run back down this way a minute. So the other spot I got's here, 29.137. On a 15 clip, which would put you in that 7.3 hole. Makes no bloody sense to be up here. But these are the coordinates and the directions that I were given. So for the minute, we'll stick with them. Oh, touch on the potato here. Well, thought about second thoughts. No, yes, come back. Well, the line's on the move this time. No monster, but it's a bit bigger than the last one. I guess the only benefit of doing it from this spot here is that I've bettered my personal best cast twice while I've been here. A little bit of a stick in the mud here, the doesn't want to come in too easy. He's up on top there now. I can't see him yet. My eyes aren't that good. Well, he came in pretty easy up until this spot. He was even up on the surface there for a little bit. Slowly, slowly, we're getting him. Well, saw a tail then. Grassy, eh? Well, come on, fella, give it up. Oh, I see what the problem is. Not paying attention as usual. There we go. Get a bit of coffee in. Well, it's definitely not a grassy, is it? Well, there you go. I think that's my first wild carp. Very nice. Not going to get too far out there this time. There's no monster. This one, another little baby fish. Vulgar sander. I think that'll be my first one of those. It's a pretty little fish, isn't it? A lot of work to get it all the way out there, but anyway. Nope, we've gone a little bit further again. Now, where are you? Right, quickly have a look there. I think, well, it's going to be right down the bottom, isn't it? The vol RSTUV. No, I've caught one at Sarah River before. Okay. That was a long, long time ago, as in years ago. Literally. And the wildcat, that's the one I just caught here. So he was definitely a first. So what else have I caught here? The rudd, another new one. The pumpkin seed sunfish, another new one. I thought there was another one or two. No, looks about it. So I guess now this is going to go quiet on this bottom fishing now for the daytime. I don't think this one was ever far enough down, and probably, although the bait's reasonable. Park that one. Now, where's the, this one? You go in there. Now what do I want to do with this one? Medium mate's good. And the maggot's good actually. Let's see, I'd like to go a bit lighter. Okay, put that one on there. I think we'll give up on these ones for now. I think we've done our damage. I'm just going to move down to that other spot I just walked down to before. Throw a couple of rods out. Fish for something different. Okay, put him away, and one of these guys. In there. Yeah. And stonefly. Try that. Probably on a 15 clip when we get there. Nope, not one. Did you get one? No. So at least we've got one decent fish out there. I don't know that first one that I had to log out on, I was going to get spooled. I don't think we got him, but yeah. What number was this one? 29137. It was just near this tree. Yeah. Okay. Okay, see what happens to those two. It's just another spot that I was given to catch fish, so. See what happens. Pontic shad, too small to keep. Another new species. Too small to keep that. We can go back. I think that makes it maybe 14 species we've caught today, or 15 maybe. I haven't kept one of these yet. I haven't caught one big enough to keep. I think I've caught three of them, throwing them all back. Same one again, the maggot. It's on the move. Throwback bream. Okay. Give him a different one to look at. I think since I changed over and put the steel leader on, we're definitely not getting as many fish, but already caught two pike. There he goes again on the old maggot. There were some common rates of bloody things. We're about 15, aren't we? Yep. No. Let's try, I was going to say, here we go again, Mr. Pike. Oh, come on, man. That's the second one that's got off spinning today. Jesus. They freaking where? Oh, get on there. Nowhere at all. I think that one's on there again. Another minnow. Oh, these bream, seriously. Let's try a caster on there. I've no idea if it's going to be any better, but I'm sick of catching that little bream. Okay, let's try this one again. Another monster. Look out. Too small. Makes you wonder how that fish gets it in his mouth. I think if a bream's taking that caster, I'm nearly going to cry. It has, isn't it? Come on, man. 500 at least, I can make him a bait. Not ready to take it yet, okay. Give him a different colour to look at. Don't know how well these sort of ones work here, but doesn't hurt to have a go. Something small. Damn, I still can't catch one of these with a tag on it. They're all too small. Now, if you're going to take it, take it. Another tiddler. Another one of these guys. If there's a fish on there, it's tiny. No fish on there yet. Okay. Change the lure again to something different. All right. Chub. At least got a tag on it. I don't know if I can where are we? No. I don't think this rain's helping us much. I guess this little guy don't worry about the rain. A sickle, little fellow. Caught a much bigger one than that before. Still can't cut him up for bait. Get out. Let's put him that way. You're aiming at the right spot. Let me just go again. No, got off. Okay. No. Just look down there for a tick. Go and check something. Okay. So when it gets a little darker, I'm just going to fish from this same spot here and hit that 7.3 hole again. But I need to cast about 30 metres rather than the 60 odd metres I was doing up the other spot. Come on, man, get on with it. Must be so small. Eat it or bugger off, one or the other. Yeah, well, this will definitely make him come out. Got a little bit quiet in here. What else can we try? I've got an idea that's too big. No, no, you can do that one. Even old Mr. Pike's gone to bed, not coming out to play anymore. Jesus, garbage bream. I don't change bait. I'll put a mayfly on this one. Maybe I'll at least keep the brim away. Oh, the rain's buggered off. Remember, we were more or less getting a whack every cast before, now we're struggling a bit. Up a little bit. No, no good there again on it. Give this one a go. Oh, dear me. Right, one last cast with it before that. We'll change over the big guns again. Well, not quite a monster this one. Gram pike. Oh, no. If I come this way a little bit and point that way. There. Now I think I'll have to probably set this around 30. And we want this one up there, and this one in there. Why did that not work? Okay. Makes sense. Kind of. Quickly about 30. Well then, see if we can catch one tonight. And we did right, we got that 9 kilo wild carp, but trying to get that one that nearly spooled us before. The only two burbot we've got down there have been tiny little buggers. Come on, mate, take it. No, changed his mind. Must have got a better option somewhere else. It's a bit like fishing at amber now. get a fish. Come on, then. Super quiet here. It was better in the other spot. Much longer cast, so 60. Well, I think you finish in the same bit of water, to be honest. We got this guy here last night. Be nice to catch a few more of him. A few of his mates. I don't know what other spots you can wear, where else. Maybe. Yeah. Down here, I guess, maybe. Yeah, lots of places to investigate here. I've only done about four spots. Well, a little tap there. No. Well, there we go. Yeah, it's okay. Damn it, man. Wrong button. A bit of current here, the lines tend to drag a bit. Well, the fishing that we did last night was quite a bit superior to this. At least we've got a couple of little burbot and bits and pieces. Could be a long night for us if we don't get a bite or two soon. Well, I don't know where else to go yet, so we'll stick it out. Oh, it's so quiet. Nothing going down. Wow. What are we going to do here? The sun will be up in a minute. We'll go back. Where will we go? We'll go back near where we started, I think. Stick it out here till the sun comes up, which won't be very long at all. The fuck? Didn't do my ears any good at all, anybody else's. Oh, what happened there? What was I going to check? I was going to check the other region weeklies. These things. Worms and night crawlers. Okay. Right, I've had enough of this spot. This is driving me nuts. This is terrible. Now, get out of here. Hopefully the spot I've just picked to go to performs a little better than this one. You might have to use a heavier basket here. Seems to be a lot of current dragging that a long way down the river. Okay. Well, all I can say that spot is thanks for nothing. I guess we've got one wild carp and a couple of pike out of just a little bit up the road, but in general it was pretty average there. Which is the worst sound. We'll do a quick stab in the cafe, but I don't think we've got anything for there. Yeah, These ones here, we never got any of them. Well, that size anyway. Didn't catch them. We got them, but not that big. No, we never got chub that big. All right, we're done. Get over here. This will be disappointing for sure. Well, I suppose I don't pay too bad, thank goodness. Another 50. Certainly not a not a day for cash, that's for sure. But it's all about the experience here. I'm quite enjoying it actually. Well, can we get through there or not? No? Yes, maybe. Okay. Now what? Now you have to go back. Thanks for the trick. Okay. I've already fished this spot here, it didn't do overly well. So we'll try this one. Let's change these rods over again. One more time. We'll put that one in there for the nighttime fish. A cup of tea and coffee while we're doing it. Let's go about 12. Looks about the middle to me, somewhere like that. And this one will change that to a red worm. What have we got on this one? No quip. We'll go 10. See what happens there, guys. No idea. Let's see if there's anything spinning. Yeah, bait. You will pay the price, Mr. Pike. Thank you. Much appreciated. Okay, let's try something a little different here. Should have had a look at the record first, shouldn't I? See what they're actually taking. Have a quick look. Nothing here. Okay. Okay, that one, only one. That was a long time ago. That's probably not worth wasting time fishing for them here. So I might just do this one and yeah, I don't think this is going to be very successful. Okay. Park this one. Let's see if we can have some fun. I'll tell you what, we'll do it with this one. Okay. The big pike grabs this one, it'll just snap it. This is the deadest spot we've been to. Without doubt. Hopefully it'll break us off. I don't think we've got a hope in hell of getting this guy in. We might get him, might just take time. The running game. Get after that fish. Glad it's only a small pike, otherwise you'd have bitten us off by now. Hopefully he's going to run out of steam before we do. I think you can't run forever, surely. Guess we'll just have to bide our time with this one. I'm not going to be slowing down too much just yet. How far down the map are we going? These are going away. I think them runs are getting a little bit weaker. Still thinking it's just a pike, and it's probably around 2 kilo. But they're a bit of fun on this light gear. Still want to fight in that last little bit. Two-kilo pike and ultralight, not bad. Better run a mile for him though. Go back and see what's happening with these pair. If we've got no fish on these two, we'll pick up sticks and come back to this spot just here. We did okay there before. That's what we first fished and we got here. And didn't catch any massive fish, but certainly caught variety. What's happening to these two here? Probably nothing by the look of them. Yeah. I don't know if this is going to be any better going down the other spot. It was much better there earlier than what we've had here, so. Fingers crossed that it's a bit better. That's not the one. Don't want that one. Yeah, we'll stick with the lightweight. I think I'll have more fun with this one. Doesn't take much of a fish to stir this one up. Like that one. Here we are back on another pike, I think. Yep, another pike for sure. Poor old reel. That last guy, we had to chase him a long, long way down. I don't really think this one's as big as that other one. That one with 1.9. I'm not feeling that this one's as big. And again, I could be wrong. Could be the same size. I hope we don't have to chase him all the way down as far as we did the last one. Run, you little beggar. We'll have to check the friction on this one later. This was about where we got ended up with the last guy, wasn't it? Something like here. Oh dear. I hope he's running out of steam. Gotta be running out shortly. Well, I think he's getting weaker and weaker. Come on, fella, give it up. Didn't make note of the time we started fighting this guy, so I've got no idea how long we've been doing it. Maybe this one is a bit bigger than the last one. This is certainly a harder fight. That's when you think you got him tired out, off he goes again. Where does he get the strength? Well, man, I'm guessing it's going to be a pike, which would be nice if it was something else. It'd be a decent size. got to be due to give up, surely. One turn at a time is about all I'm getting. Maybe we got him here. Crazy fish. Come on, man. You're done. It's nearly dark. It's that last little bit. He wants to fight every inch of the way. Last little bit, come on, buddy. Doesn't look like a pike. It is, isn't it? It is a pike there. Oh, it's an asp, 2.64. Well, that'd be my biggest for sure. Well, that was a fight and a half for that, wasn't it? A fight and a half. Now, see if I can't get lost on the way back. Long way to go. Nothing. Not a thing. Wow, did I have that reel open? They're lucky it didn't get spooled here. Sometimes I reckon I click it, and it doesn't work for some reason. Well, this has got a tag on it, which is a bonus for a bream around here. Well, yeah, I did catch a 2.9 kilo bream here first time I was here. Earlier today. So yeah, we certainly got a number of varieties of fish today, that's for sure. I don't know if we'll spin. Let's change the lure. Don't think we're going to get much at night, but so we're nearly going 4 hours and thinking about wrapping up shortly. It's been a good day. I've enjoyed fishing here, and the time's flying by really quick. Just need to do some more study on it and find some better, slightly better spots. And I think we can come back here and catch a lot of fish. I don't think it's a place to go for a silver grind, but I think in the first hour here we'd caught like 15 species of fish, so yeah. Obviously a lot of them are throwbacks, but nonetheless. Put that one away and give it a couple of minutes. We did get a lot of bites here first time we came here today, non-stop pretty much. Not the case right now. We've had quite a few people drop into the stream today, so thanks to all them guys, and thanks to you guys that are here right now. I do appreciate people coming in here, even if you do lurk, it's fine. Right, I think I'm done. We'll rip these in and go and sell our three fish. Three fish. Certainly haven't sold a lot of fish today. I think 17 in the first hour we sold. But my God, we threw a lot back. And I just think the scenery in this map's amazing. Except for the barren bits and pieces, they could have done something with that. Yeah, in the right direction, aren't we? Of course we're not. I was wondering why I couldn't see any town lights or anything. So we don't really have much to sell, so I don't recall seeing anything in the cafe for an asp. So we'll just go straight to the fish market and sell them off there. And I think on Monday, well, I reckon I might have leveled up on by Monday. I'll do a bit over the weekend offline. See if I can't level up, and then we'll go. Well, whatever the next map is, I forget what it is. Tiny Brim, yeah, not going to get much of these, but no, he's not bad. $22 for himself. Yeah. Righto. Once again, peeps, thanks for being here. Thanks for hanging out. And everyone have a great weekend. And take care. And I'll see you all Monday, hopefully. Bye for now.